Hi, and on this video we're going to, this project and video, we're going to look at how to control both a garage door and electric gates. This project's probably been gone on a little bit longer than I first anticipated, and this was due to coming up with the best solution, or a solution, you know, the best solution, either the price or you know, how we're going to do this. So there's many ways we could look at this problem, but I thought, okay, I think I've come up with a solution that's a compromise. So it's a compromise on price and a compromise on actual physical work, what we'll need to do to get this to work. So originally I started off with the original four channel, but this is very limited, great device, but limited, just basically a four channel basic device. So, and now we've got hold of the four channel pro, and we can, this is how we're gonna move forward with this project. Again, moving forward, we've figured out with the 4-channel Pro, we can use the inching mode. And so this will replicate if you press the button. Then I thought, okay, we've got the inching mode and we can go on to a timer. So we could hardwire this device to both the gates and this is a relay timer. So this again would accept an input, then count down to replicate pressing a button. Again, yeah, it's a doable project, but you've got to start hardwiring cables into both devices. So my conclusion with this one is the 4-channel Pro in inching mode, and we're going to bring in a remote. Now, the difference with these remotes are, and I see we've got a bit of confusion, these basic remotes are fixed codes. Codes for gates and garage doors have a rolling code, and this is similar to what you have in the car. So once you've pressed it, both devices then change to a new code, so people can't replicate your key fob and gain entry. So I'll pause the video and let's have a look what we do. Okay, so we've got the cover off, and we're going to set this up. So first what we need to do is change over S6, and this is going to change from inching, latching, from interlock. So that's going to be inching and latching from the interlock, so that's going to be swapped over first. Then we're going to go to K5, this one here, and we're going to set that to 0. So then we've already selected inching, latching, so now this decides what it's going to be. It's going to be inching or latching. So now we change it to inching, and then we go to K6, this one here, and we're just going to knock down the first tab, the first dip switch there, and that should give us about 2-3 seconds. We're going to change this and see how it looks. So we can set it up first, and then we're going to look at the remote and put some power to this. Okay, we have powered up the device. I'm only running low voltage DC, I think 6 volt DC on this one, not using the 240 volts AC line, too dangerous with the cover off, so never run the high voltage AC line with the cover off. We have previously set the dip switches because we're going to run this in inching mode. We've done many videos before, so we know how to pair these devices up by exactly the same procedure. Press and hold one of the buttons when the LED starts flashing, then we use the app to pair and connect to the Wi-Fi. So we've done that, we've set it all up. Say, if you look at some of my other videos, it'll go in a little more in depth on how to set up these devices, so we don't really need to do that again today. And we have named two of the channels, garage door and the gate. So we've done that, and so here goes. Alexa, garage door on.
Okay.
And there we go. So I say we might need to adjust the timing part of this, but it looks like it's all running smoothly. And we can just try Alexa, gate on.
The Lightning will play tonight at 9 p.m. against the Devils. The Predators
Alexa,
will play tonight.
Cancel.
The Warriors will play
Alexa, cancel. This is how she's absolutely crazy. Alexa, turn gate on. There you
okay.
go. Obviously, she's struggling with my voice today. I'll try again. Alexa, garage door on. Yeah, that's
okay.
better. There you go. So that's working. So what we'll do now... We'll go over to the key fob, we'll break into this, and we'll have a look at the wiring. I'll just pause the video. I've taken the cover off the key fob there, and you can see the two buttons there. So if we flip over the board, you'll notice there's actually four, if I can focus in there, there's the four tabs on each button. Two for the contacts, and... the other two are really just keeping the button stable. So what I've done is soldered two cables on there. What I will do, I'll pause the video and I'm going to solder another two cables on. Now this wire, really thin, nice wire, and what I've done, I've just got this from an old RJ45 patch cable. It's a very thin cable and nice to solder with. And as you know, we've all got these laying around the house or bottom of drawers, and they only end up getting thrown away. So it's a good use of a cable, and we're coated up. So again, I'll pause the video. We're going to solder the second two on, and then we'll connect up to our 4-channel Pro. We've got both of the wires now, nicely colour coded, lovely cables to use, and very easy to solder. So we've got both cables now soldered onto the back of the board there, onto both buttons. And we can reassemble back into the case. And then what I'm going to do, there's many ways we could have looked at this project, many ways we could have wired it. We could have hardwired it, we could have, used the RF remotes. But this is the option I'm going to use today. Again, it's a compromise. Everybody knows we can do this many, many ways. And I thought this one is just a compromise where we can use a key fob, take advantage of the RF, and take advantage of this 4-channel Pro with the inching mode. And then what I'm going to do, I will then wire up this. And I think if you remember, we were using these two channels here for the door and the gate. So Alexa, gate on.
Okay.
Aha, so that's this one here for the gate, and I guess that was the door. Alexa, garage door on. Yes.
Okay.
That's that one, that's garage door, and that's that one. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is once we've got it all wired up, I'm going to probably position this inside. I'll see if this will go inside, and then it's all a nice, neat unit, and we can position this somewhere safe. All right, so again, pause the video, and we'll just... finally tie up these few wires. I have got the cover back on, and I've managed to get the remote inside nice and neatly. And I could have soldered those cables at the back there, but for a 2-minute job, just clipped them and they've gone between the two sets of terminals there. I'm only going to be running this on low voltage on 6 volts DC. And then what I've done, I've gone over to my EWE link account, and I've set it up as garage door and gate. So what I'll do now for the final time, pause the video, go and fasten this to the wall, and then I'll show you Alexa and Google. Right, it's on the wall, powered up, connected to the Wi-Fi, and okay Google, garage door on.
Channel Pro garage door on.
All working perfect. And I'll just catch that baby with Alexa. When it's closed, I'll just wait. We can actually do it by Alexa, or we can do it by via Google. So there you go. Okay, Google. Okay, Google. Gate on.
Okay, turning the 4-channel Pro gate on.
There we go. So it does exactly what we wanted it to do. And I say it's all been a compromise. You know, I could have hardwired it in. I could have used many different options, but I thought for this one, just a bit of fun, quick and easy, all done and dusted. Let's try it one more time. Alexa, gate on. Go, all perfect, super. Thanks very much for watching the video, and please subscribe. There's some more projects coming along, and it's all a bit of fun, but please subscribe and let's do some more of these projects. Thank you very much.